was so fun.
I love getting out and about. Ooh, it's a little chilly. Oh, it's so nice.
So great inside. Chappelle, it's so nice to have you here.
So great to be here.
Oh, we just did so many wonderful things in the community. It's the best gift that we can give is actually just to give to others.
I think it's right. You're right. Absolutely.
But we're a little pooped, so we need a little bit of nourishment, and then we also need to get stuff ready for Santa and all our friends and our family tonight.
And our party.
I think I can help you.
So what do we have?
We have all kinds of great stuff, which has been brought you for the season by our friends at Whole Foods in Hadley. And we have, I'm going to start with some pineapple, because in Hawaii, of course, it's mele kalikimaka.
It's a thing to say,
and here we call it a pineapple. But here's what I'm going to do, and I've got an example right here, but I'm going to turn the top of this pineapple into a Christmas tree.
Okay.
And so just another nice tabletop decoration, or it could be your entire tree for the season.
This will be perfect for our party.
It will be, because here's the first thing you want to do, is you want to take the top off. Now, even though it's a nice even cut, sometimes it comes out a little cockeyed, but that came out well. Now, you see how it's kind of like a little dull greenish, little powder on it?
It's dreary.
It's dreary.
It doesn't scream holiday season.
It does. It looks more like the Charlie Brown Christmas tree.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We're going to make it into even better one. We're going to put it into hot water, boiling water, and what happens is, as you put it in the hot water, it brings all the color out. See, literally just moments.
Ooh.
And now we're gonna plunge it into ice water because technically I've just started to cook that and I don't wanna do that. So I'm just gonna move this pan over to here. So I don't wanna do that. So I'm just letting it stop the cooking for just a brief moment. And so now we've got this wet pineapple thing. That's a technical culinary term.
Wet pineapple thing that we're going to turn into a tree.
We're gonna turn it into a tree, a Christmas tree. This is perfect if you live in an apartment. Especially if you're up in the 8th floor, it's so hard to carry a tree upstairs.
I can imagine, or if you just like pineapple.
Exactly, and this is so easy to carry around. So now, here's the thing, you do want to dry it as much as you can because one of the steps helps. Oh boy, thank you,
Steph. Well, that's what the season's all about.
It's the spirit of the season, of giving.
This is part of the fun, is just making everything together.
It is, you know, and kitchens really should be, whether it's with kids or with everybody, have everybody into the kitchen and have fun in there. See, a lot of times people say to me, well, gee, I go crazy, they say to me, when I've got other people in the kitchen. And I say, no, I go crazy when it's nobody else in the kitchen. It's fun to kind of chat and catch up with stuff. And it's fun, especially this time of year.
Oh, yeah, that's true. I mean, usually when I'm in the kitchen, I'm like, get out. I have no idea what I'm doing, and I don't want anyone to witness it.
Well, there's that, too.
All right, so once it's dry, what's the next step?
The next step is we're going to put it on, we call this a tree stand. And we're going to put it on right like that. So now it calls for some snow because it is the season. I'm going to reach right over here. And instead of snow, we're going to go with confectioner sugar. And so you just kind of tap it. Now, a lot of times people think you either shake it or use a spoon. Actually, put it in a strainer and don't hit your hand against it. Hit the strainer against your hand. Otherwise, you get big clumps out. And this is another reason why you wanted this dried as much as possible. Because if the leaves are wet, it'll absorb and won't show all of the great looking snow that we're putting on here.
That is just so festive.
It is, it's very festive.
Now, if we want to decorate our tree, how do we do it?
Decorate tree, I think ornaments might tip it over.
That might be, yeah.
So what we like to do, and I've done it right here, is string together just a needle and thread. I've got some popcorn, I've got some cranberries. I don't have to cook them, don't have to be dried cranberries, just some fresh cranberries. And a lot of times of the year, you can't get cranberries, but this time of year,
So many cranberries.
Absolutely. So these won't be difficult to find. And then you can put little presents under the tree. I think strawberries look real cool.
You don't even have to do anything. Just rinse them off and they're ready to go.
Exactly. So it's just a great little festive tabletop thing to do. And so here we've got this one. And then we've got this one all decorated and ready to go. Lights might be a little bit of a problem.
We probably shouldn't light the tree. Now, what are we going to do with the rest of our pineapple?
Well, now here's the great thing. A lot of people think, since you've already taken the valuable top off, throw away the rest. However, I disagree. And so here's what you want to do. You want to cut up the rest of the pineapple. So just cut it like that and just take the skin off.
Now, easier said than done, Chef Bill. Can I try?
Oh, please do. Because, you know, I love the deli knife with the big serrated...
Okay.
With serrated teeth on it.
So you hide your fingers.
Absolutely. Boy, you've done this before.
Not as well, but, you know, how am I doing?
You're better than me. I'm going to have to go into a new line of work.
Usually I open up a can. But this is working.
Wait a minute, you can get pineapple in a can?
Yeah, you never heard of that?
Well, if you can get the top in a can, that would
change everything. You can't make a tree out of it.
You can.
And that's why I'm in the pineapple game.
Happy holidays.
Beautiful. Oh, there that's beautiful. So now I'm just going to put these over here, right like that. And so now we're going to cut this in quarters because you've got that core up the middle. Now, the great thing about the core is you don't have to throw it out. You can still use it. You simmer it up in some water, and you have a nice little juicy pineapple juice you can have with tea. So it makes a great tea or a great other flavor.
And
You could do it with simple syrup for cocktails and sugar.
Oh, it's perfect. Exactly.
My kids fight over it like it's corn on the cob.
Oh, you've got great kids. That's the perfect thing. Absolutely, because a lot of people just throw it out. It's a great healthy thing. So now I'm just, because I've got it on the angle like this, I can just take my knife and cut out the core. So now we're almost ready. Now what we're gonna be doing is, we're gonna be caramelizing. You can just take off some of those bits if you want. We're gonna be caramelizing the pineapple pieces. So just cut it like that.
It's okay, Bill, you can say I didn't do a good enough job.
Oh, you did a perfect
job. My feelings won't be hurt. I'm here to learn and have fun.
Well, that's it, it's the season. So now, what you wanna do is you wanna sprinkle with some sugar. On all sides.
Snow.
It's snow, yeah. That's right. Well, this is regular sugar. It doesn't have to be confectioner sugar.
Right.
And that's the great thing about this time of year. We can take something healthy like fruit and turn it into candy.
It.
Exactly. Add sugar and add all kinds of fun things to it.
Just when you thought pineapple wasn't sugary and sweet enough.
Exactly. Now it's even more so. So now you kind of put it on there. I've got some butter simmering along here.
Ooh, I can't wait to toast with my caramelized pineapple.
Exactly.
As we celebrate.
Yeah.
And so just drop it in. And this takes about 10 minutes or so, which is about the time I'm thinking Santa will be coming down the chimney.
Mm-hmm.
So
Santa?
Santa.
Ooh, he's coming tonight.
He hit this. That's exactly it. I'm just going to move this over here.
Now, do you have to use tongs to kind of flip it? Or?
Yep, you do need to use tongs, but that's, you give that a few minutes. So now that's ready to just sit and simmer 10 minutes, 12 minutes. And what's going to happen? Oh, look, I happen to have some right here.
It's a Christmas Eve miracle.
It's a Christmas Eve miracle, but we're going to make that even better. Because what can make sugared caramelized pineapple even better? I think hot fudge sauce.
Oh. Whoa.
Oh, look, now you can just kind of present it any way you want. And I like to just try to drizzle a little bit over there.
Oh, wow.
And the thing is, you've got the whole rest of the bowl, or you can just dip it into it. You can cut the pineapple into pieces. There's just so many great ways to do it.
I might leave this out for Santa.
I had one more gift I had to buy, but this could be the end.
This could be the one.
And then, wait, in case you hadn't done enough damage yet, we have some freshly whipped cream.
Well, isn't this something? It is indeed going to be a Merry Christmas.
It is, and you know, put this under the tree. Santa might decide to go with this instead of the cookies.
Okay, cookies.
So we're
going
to bring this to the table.
And our
tree. Our tree to the table. We are going to have the best Christmas party ever. Chef Bill, keep cooking. We're going to go
away.
Start getting everything ready at our table.
Oh, here, put it right down.
Here.
Come on.
Kathleen.
Oh, that looks beautiful. It's the holiday season.
That's right. Look
there
at this.
It is. All right,